morning, students. Right, so in this session, we will see the
basic dynamic load rating. Basic dynamic load rating. So, load rating is nothing but a constant radial or axial load. Constant radial or axial load that a group of bearings can carry for L10 life. Okay. So, what is the maximum radial load or what is the maximum axial load that 90% of the group of the bearings can carry? 90% of the group of the bearings can carry. 90% of the group of the bearings are nothing but the bearings with the L10 life. The bearings with L10 life. So, basic dynamic load rating simply, it is a constant radial or sometimes axial load also we will consider here while calculating that value. So that if you look at the equation, you can understand, right? So it is a constant radial in radial load bearings or axial load in axial loading or thrust bearings that a group of bearings can carry for L10 life. Okay. So that is nothing but basic dynamic load rating, and which is generally indicated with capital C. The notations are more important here in the design. So capital C indicates basic dynamic load rating. L10 indicates rated life. L50 indicates average life. L50 indicates average life of the bearing. Okay. So come to the design considerations. The bearings are selected from the catalogs. Before referring to the catalogs, you should know the following. Right? Bearing load. Either radial load or a thrust load or combination of both. Right? The load acting on the bearing may be a radial load or a thrust load or the combination of both. Right? So, look at this. Here, this is the bearing. The bearing will be like this. If it acts along the radial direction, then this is called a radial load, right? You know the designation of bearings on the shaft. This is how the bearings are represented on the shaft. So these are the shaft ends, which are mounted on two bearing supports. So it is a simply supported beam. Now here there is a gear blank here, spur gear, and there is another gear blank. Let us take a helical gear. Right? Like this, you can also take another pulley for bell drive. Right? So, apart from these radial loads, the shaft axis is subjected to another load. The load which is along the axis of the shaft is nothing but axial load. What is the other name for axial load? Thrust load. Okay. So, while designing a bearing, you must take the bearing load. This bearing load may fall either purely on radial loads or purely on thrust load or axial load, or sometimes some of the bearings like angular contact bearings are subjected to both radial loads or both radial loads and axial loads. Right? Angular contact bearings are effective enough to bear both radial loads and thrust loads. Okay. So, first, with the given data, first you have to identify what type of loads are acting on the bearing. Whether it is purely radial load or whether it is purely axial load or the combination of both radial and axial load. That's what you need to observe here. Okay. Right? So then, next parameter you need to remember in the design of bearing is bearing life. What is the bearing life? Okay. So, from this bearing life, you need to calculate L10 life. Okay. Sometimes you will be given bearing life L50. What is L50? Average life. Okay. 50% reliability, 100 minus 50, 50% failure rate. Right? But in the design calculations, always the bearing life must be rated life. Bearing life must be rated life. Because you should not consider the failure rate equal to the success rate. That's what happening in the average life of the bearing. Okay, always the success rate or the reliability must be higher, right? So based on number of iterations and calculations, the optimal reliability will be considered as 90%. If the reliability is 90%, failure rate is 10%, and that life is designated with L suffix 10. That is called L10 life, right? So if the bearing life is L10, what is the reliability? 90% reliability. In terms of decimals, 0.9 is the reliability. What is the failure rate? 1 minus 0.9. 0.1 is the failure rate, right? You can simply remember, reliability is nothing but success rate. If you consider a group of 100 bearings, 90 bearings will not get any failure within that life period. Remaining 10 bearings, there is a chance of getting failure. That's what the reliability and life, right? If there are 10 bearings in that group, 90% of the group, that means 9 bearings will not get any failure within the life of 10 hours or 20 hours or whatever it is, right? Remaining 10%, that means 1 bearing, right? We cannot give the guarantee for that one bearing, right? It may fail within the specified life of 10 hours or 5 hours. Okay, so let us take the specified life. L10 life is some 10 hours, right? So 9 bearings will cross this 10 hours life. Only one bearing, there is a chance of failure within this 10 hours. Okay. So, if we consider 100 bearings, 90 bearings will cross this 10 hours and 10 bearings may fail within this 10 hours. Okay. Right, so that's what you need to consider. And the third parameter you need to remember, the speed at which the bearing is rotating. The speed at which the bearing is rotating, that is called the bearing speed, RPM of the bearing. Okay. Then, the space limitations. Based on the space restrictions, sometimes the inner race is rotating, sometimes outer race is rotating, sometimes both are stationary. Based on this, we need to consider suitable design factors. Okay. Then accuracy of the power transmission or the accuracy of the shaft and alignments, right? All this, the accuracy of the bearing mounting or the accuracy of the entire assembly. Okay. Then equivalent radial load. So this is another important factor along with the dynamic load rating. The symbol used to specify this dynamic load rating is C. Okay. Equivalent radial load. So the bearings are usually operated with some combination of radial and thrust loads, right? Sometimes the bearings are designed only for radial loads. Sometimes the bearings are designed only for thrust loads, like a footstep bearing. It is designed only for thrust loads. Okay. So sometimes the bearings are designed only for radial loads, like a ball bearing used in the bicycle axle. Right? Sometimes the bearings are subjected to combination of both radial and thrust loads. Okay. So under this case, you need to calculate equivalent loads. The catalog ratings are based only on radial loads. Okay. So though the load acting on the bearing are radial and thrust loads, but the catalog ratings generally only based on the radial loads. So that's why we need to follow the guidelines in the catalogs while designing the gears. So catalog in the sense, data. Right, to obtain the equivalent radial load. So to calculate this equivalent radial load, we have standard equation, right? Equivalent radial load P is equal to, right? So this is a very, very important relation you need to remember here. Equivalent radial load P is equal to, this is simply by default, it is considered as equivalent load P is equal to X into V into FR. X into V into FR plus Y into FA, where FR is radial load acting on the bearing. FA is axial load acting on the bearing. Right? XA is radial load factor. Y is axial load factor. And V is rotation factor. V is a rotation factor. Listen once again. Though the bearings are subjected to different types of loads, both radial and thrust loads, in the design of bearing, you need to design the bearing for a single load. Right? That is available in our manufacturer's catalog or design data book. That is nothing but equivalent radial load. Whatever may be the type of load given, you need to convert all these loads into equivalent radial load. To calculate this equivalent radial load, an empirical relation is given here, x into v into fr plus y into fa, where fr is radial load acting on the bearing, fa is axial load acting on the bearing, x is radial load factor, y is axial load factor, v is rotation factor. What is v here? Rotation factor. X and Y are load factors corresponding to radial and thrust loads respectively. Right? The values of this X and Y depends on the ratio of FR by FA. The ratio of axial load by radial load. FA by FR. The ratio of these loads. FA by FR. Right? Decides the values of X and Y which are available in our manufacturer's catalog. And V is rotation factor. This rotation factor value depends on the rotating element, whether the inner race is rotating or the outer race is rotating. Right? If the inner race is rotating, V is equal to 1. If the outer race is rotating, V is greater than 1. Okay. So these values available in our data book. Right? So, X is radial load factor, Y is thrust load factor, and V is rotational factor. Okay. And series, bearing series. Okay. Just like the classification of bearings, the bearings are classified into different types based on the load rating. Right? So, heavy series, medium series, light series, extremely light series, extra light series, and extremely light series. Okay, if the bearing is able to withstand high loads, then that is called a heavy bearing series, and this is designated with number four in the 100th place. Right? Similarly, if it is a medium type of loading on the bearing, right, then it is designated with the number 3 in the 100th place. Right? 1st place, 10th place, 100th place. So, all these digits 4, 3, 2, 1 are in the 100th place. Okay. So, next, light series designated with 2 in the 100th place, and extra light is designated with 1, right? And extremely light designated with 19, is designated with 19. Generally, we won't go for this extremely light series, right? If you look at this figure, the size of the bearing is slightly increasing. That's this increase in the size indicates the increase in the load carrying capacity of the bearing. That's what you need to observe here. It is not exactly the size. It also reflects the load carrying capacity. Okay. Right. And here, the first two digits in the bearing number, represents right, the diameter of the bearing. Okay, so first two digits multiplied with 5 multiplied with 5 indicates the diameter of the bearing. Okay, for example, if it is 420 bearing or 415 bearing, bearing number SKF415, what is the diameter of that? 15 into 5, last two digits are 1 and 5, right? Suppose if the bearing number is 324, 24 into 5, what is that? 120 mm. That is the diameter of the bearing. Diameter of the medium series bearing with a bore of 120 mm. So this is the radius of the bearing bore. Okay, so that's how the bearings are designated with different series, right? So bearing is designated with certain number, right? This number consists of 3 digits, right? First 2 digits, that means a digit in the first ones place, digit in the tens place, multiplied by 5 indicates the diameter or the bore of the bearing, right? And the third digit indicates bearing series number, the type of bearing series, heavy series, medium series, or low series, or extremely light series. That's what is specified by third digit. Next one, relationship between life of the bearing and the equivalent load. Already we have calculated equivalent load P is equal to XVFR plus YFA. XVFR plus YFA. So that is equivalent load, right? So here we have two types of bearings. Bearings with L2 life, bearings with L1 life. Bearings with L1 life. So L1 life bearings having an equivalent load of P1. L2 life bearings are having a life of, sorry, L2 life bearings having an equivalent load of P2. Now, P1 is a load on first group, P2 is load on equivalent load on second group. L1 and L2 are lives of first and second group. Okay, right? So, this is, first look at this equation. This is the relation between life of the bearing, equivalent load, and what is C here? C is the dynamic load rating. C is the dynamic load rating. This is important relation. Life of the bearing is equal to C by P, whole to the power of k million revolutions. C by k million revolutions, where k is equal to 3 for ball bearing, where k is equal to 3.33 for ball bearing. Okay, based on this relation, you can write the relation between life and the equivalent load. So life is inversely proportional to the equivalent. Life is inversely proportional to the equivalent load. So that's why L2 by L1 is equal to P1 by P2 whole to the power of k. Since C is common for given type of bearing, that's why L is equal to C by P whole to the power of K can be modified for two groups of bearings. L2 by L1 is equal to P1 by P2 whole to the power of K. What if this K here, K is a constant. This K is equal to 3 for ball bearings, right? And for roller bearings, it is 10 by 3 or the 3.333 and so on. Okay. So here onwards, if the rolling contact bearing is a ball bearing, right, you need to consider k is equal to 3. If the rolling contact bearing is a roller bearing, k is equal to 10 by 3. Okay. Now, the relation between life in hours, life in million revolutions, life in revolutions. So, bearing life, how do you define bearing life? Bearing life is defined as number of revolutions the bearing can complete. Number of revolutions the bearing can complete before the first evidence of failure. first evidence of failure, right? What is the total number of revolutions the bearing can complete before the failure stops? Right? That is the definition of life. In other words, number of hours the bearing can work before the first evidence of failure. Both in both the case the criteria is same. First evidence of failure criterion met. Right? So in one case we are considering rotational motion, number of revolutions the bearing can complete, and in second case number of hours the bearing can work. So that means there is similarity in both the cases in defining bearing life in terms of two parameters. One is in terms of revolutions, or one is in terms of hours the bearing can work. So now you can relate these two terms, life in million revolutions or life in revolutions. Life in revolutions, L equal to life in hours into revolutions per minute. Revolutions per minute into 60 minutes. Life in hours. Okay. Into revolutions per minute. You need to calculate revolutions per hour. Per minute n revolutions, so per 60 minutes 60 into n revolutions per hour, 60 n revolutions. So like this, how many hours are there? LH hours, so 60 n revolutions per hour into total number of hours gives total life in revolutions. If you divide this with the 10 to the power of say 6, 10 to the power of 6 is nothing but 10 lakhs. 10 lakhs nothing but 1 million. So if you divide this million revolutions obtained from this equation with 10 to the power of 6, you will get life in million revolutions. When the bearing is subjected to variable loads of magnitudes P1, P2, P3 and so on, right, over a period of revolutions n1, n2, n3 and so on, then you can write the equation n1 by L1 by n1 or n1 by L1 plus n2 by L2 plus and so on is equal to 1. So this you can easily understand when you solve the problem on this bearing life. We'll see in the coming classes. Right? So this is another important relation between a life and equivalent load and dynamic load rating. C is the dynamic load rating, right? And P is, this is available in our data book. P is equivalent radial load calculated from the empirical relation. P is equal to XVFR plus YFA. And L is life in million revolutions. So you need to remember this, L is always life in million revolutions. Life in whatever the life calculated from this equation is life in revolutions. And here you need to substitute life in million revolutions. You have to divide this value with 10 to the power of 6. That's what here we have included 10 to the power of 6. Now N1 by L1 is equal to N1 into, instead of L1, you can substitute here, right? You can substitute P1 by C into all the power of K divided by 10 to the power of K. Sorry, 10 to the power of 6. Okay. Then the bearing selection. So most manufacturers specify basic dynamic load rating C, which is the load that results in 10 to the power of 6 cycles. So this equation can be written as, right, design life is equal to C divided by design load all to the power of K into 10 to the power of 6, right? So don't worry about all these equations. All these equations available in our data book. Only thing is, you should know which equation is relevant for the design design. Okay, so this indicates the design life for your specific application, right? It is very easy to solve the problem on design, right? So dynamic load rating from this equation, dynamic load rating C is equal to equivalent load into design life divided by, so design life is in terms of million revolutions divided by million, you will get life in revolutions, right? 4 to the power of 1 by k, right?